Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 21 of our GoLang course. As I promised earlier, since we have covered arrays and slices in the previous lessons, in this lesson we are going to cover strings in depth and how strings work behind the scenes. So let's begin. In programming, strings are essentially sequences of individual characters. In Go, strings are stored as sequence of bytes, where each character is represented by one or more byte according to encoding use. Usually, it's UTF-8. You can access individual bytes of string using index notation. Each byte represents a character or a part of character in the string. Just like other sequences in Go, like arrays and slices, you can use slice expression with strings to extract a portion of a string. This lets you extract a substring from a string efficiently. In Go, strings are immutable, which means once a string is created, you cannot change its contents. If you want to modify a string, you will need to create a new string with the desired changes. Go allows you to convert between different types as long as types are compatible. So, in Go, you can convert a string to a slice of bytes or runes or vice versa. Runes, as we covered earlier, are used to represent Unicode characters. These concepts are fundamental to when working with strings in Go programming language. Let's look at some examples of using slice expression with strings. Here in our example, given s is a string, code and learn. In the first example, we have string, and inside the string conversion, we have the first byte of string s using again the index notation. This converts the first byte of the string, which corresponds to character c, into a string value. So the result is string c. Next, this expression extracts the slice from the beginning up to but not including index 5. This includes characters at indices 0 to 4. So the result is string code. In the next example, the expression here extracts a slice of a string starting from index 3 until the end. This includes characters at index 3 and beyond, resulting in string e and learn. Next, this slicing expression creates a complete copy of the string, essentially returning the entire string itself, which is code and learn. In the last section, I mentioned that strings are immutable. In this example, this line attempts to modify the character at index 1 of the string s to character or byte a. Sorry for the detour, but in Go, you can write both byte and rune in single quotes. Coming back to our example here, this line attempts to modify character at index 1 of string s to a. However, strings in Go are immutable, which means you cannot modify their content after they are created. This results in an error, unassignable operand, because you cannot assign a new value to a specific character in a string. In summary, these examples demonstrate various ways of manipulating and assessing parts of string in Go, along with the immutable nature of strings that prevent direct modification of their characters or byte data. In Go, when working with strings, the underlying byte data of string is assumed to be encoded using UTF-8. UTF-8 is a character encoding that represents Unicode characters using variable length sequence of bytes. Because of UTF-8 encoding and Unicode support, the characters in a string can be represented using varying length of numbers of bytes. This means a character can occupy anywhere from 1 to 4 bytes in memory. This leads to our next point. If a character in a string is represented by more than one byte, directly fetching the byte data and converting it to a string can lead to unexpected results. This is because a character might span multiple bytes, and converting each byte individually may not result in the correct character representation. Our earlier examples worked since characters in the string were one byte, which is not always the case. To handle multi-byte characters properly, you need to work with Unicode code points and rune values. In a sense, these points highlight the complexity introduced by UTF-8 encoding, which allows for representing a wide range of characters, but requires careful consideration to ensure correct character manipulation and conversion when dealing with byte data. Let's look at an example. Here, in our example, we have a string S, where most of the characters are Unicode code points that require more than one byte to be encoded. Directly assessing a single byte with an expression like this can lead to invalid output. This is because a single byte might not represent a complete character in such case. To properly handle multi-byte characters, there are few approaches. You can use functions from the strings package or Unicode UTF-8 package to work with multi-byte characters and manipulate strings correctly. These packages provide utilities to deal with UTF-8 encoded strings. Another approach is to convert the string to a slice of runes. Runes are used to represent Unicode code points. You can achieve this by using square brackets, rune, and inside the brackets, the string s. Once you have a rune slice, you can assess each character correctly using indexing, such as string r character at index 2, to get the third character as a string. So in case where s is the string, assessing characters using indices with an expression like this will give you the third character as a string. This ensures that each character, whether represented by one byte or more bytes, is assessed correctly and handled appropriately. In the next lesson, we will go over all these concepts we covered here. That's it for the lesson. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions, please leave a comment under the video or reach out to the Discord server. See you in the next lesson. Happy coding!